It's a hat and a rabbit and a hat and a rabbit. So today we are talking about the decorating of the awesome hat. See? I love it. It is the most troll market thing I've ever made, and that is a wonderful, wonderful thing. For the barnacles, I could not find any tutorials online. I could only find pictures of really intricate knotwork barnacles, and that was beyond my skill level. So this is a pile of beads surrounded by thick thread, surrounded by thin thread, and then outlined. And now you can see why I left the lining and the shell unattached. So I made sure it was right side out. I'm gonna stick my hand in here. And in the interest of being completely ridiculous, as always, I think I'm gonna start right up front with beading. Just a little stitch to anchor it, and here it is. Secondhand shop beads. Which might be responsible for getting me into this mess. I don't know. I will say it is the nature of beading to take forever. Not a great thing to be saying on your very first stitches with a new project. But I've got an idea for something like barnacles. Pretty shiny beads surrounded by, well, I'll try it. Hopefully it'll work out. Alright, for me, the fussiest part of all this is the edge where the barnacles meet whatever else you have going on. Because the infill can be a lot more casual, and it still looks good. I'll show you that in a minute. But the outside edge has to be pretty solid. Like that. I like that. Mostly I do it like that. But if you're really careful about where you pop up, and you can do it like that. So this is exactly what it looks like, just big, lazy, casual stitches and very jarring green and black that I got bored with a different part of the hat and started doing this. So I've got a few other skeins that I can use that are more subtle colors, but I'm going to save those till last. Right now, this needs more covering and more stiffening, and also the funky novelty yarn thing needs to go in more than one place, because golden rule with this sort of thing is do it in multiple places and then it'll look deliberate, right? So following that, I'm gonna infill between these big casual stitches with funky novelty yarn. Just let it form its own shapes. Okay, that way it'll look more organic, more like it grew that way.
And then there's adventures with knots in the thread already. Of course there is.
This is how the cicada came out. It is beautiful and shiny. I expected the clear beads to pick up more color, but they didn't quite. But I love them anyway. And then the segments of wings are kind of outlined with black thread. And then there's just background bead texture. Oh my god, this is taking forever. I don't think I can use very many more of the pale ones. I guess up here in this corner that needs some more. Still, got a lot left. I guess I'll just plug them into the background texture bead pile. There we go. There's the turkey tail shelf fungus, which looks very messy from up close. I should have spent more time on it, but it looks really cool anyway. And then the moss around it with the beads integrated.
Alright, with the barnacles. I'd never done anything like that before, but I knew I could make it work, right? The cicada, not a big deal at all. General texture, fun. This, though. I want some bracket fungus or turkey tails, something like that, and I have no idea if I can make it work, how to make it work. Okay, if the bigger curve is on the back, I feel like that makes it hug a little too closely. So I guess the shallower curve on the back. And crossing my fingers and hoping that I didn't make them too big. I'm gonna put some embroidered texture on them before I attach them at all, just because it seems like it'll be easier when they're still loose. We'll see. This is just more of that old bedsheet fabric, like with the cicada and the butterfly and the moth. See, this is why I should have done a sample before I went and started filming, because that first round was useless. So, bracket fungus unsurprisingly needs some stiffness. So now we're doing two layers of fabric. And just really densely stitching them together with our color of choice. I wish the background fabric was closer to the color we're going for, but using scraps, not being fussy. So we'll end up with something more like that, and then we'll put the white stripes on it, and then hopefully we can get it to look like it's supposed to. Opal the rabbit is just off frame trying to eat my slipper. Me, I'm wondering what the heck I'm doing. But I feel like the most important part of making these, on the one hand identifiable, on the other hand visually interesting, is color value variation, right? The white outlining. It's important on turkey tails. So I managed it on this one. Is that in focus? And I think if I get the little mushrooms all done like that, that'll be close enough to put on the hat and then worry about trying to integrate it and everything else. And there's five of them, because odd numbers are good and three is not enough. So, I'm going to do this for a while.
There's one thing that does transfer from painting into fiber arts is the edges are everything, which is why there's the absolute chaos of interlocking everything right here, right? Soften the edges. So, next up, breaking out these and making it look like moss is growing around my pretty little fungi, and also implicating them in everything else.